I'm going to tell you, my children do not dress after the attire, amen, of Hollywood and the newest fashion and newest style. You know why? Because Dagon ain't set up in our house. But God Jehovah set up in our house. He's gave us, amen, to God, his word. And it still teaches us how we should live and dress and be according to God's word and will. Amen. God and the world cannot mix. Next morning they come in after they set Dagon up, and Dagon fell again. This time his head was cut off, his arms were cut off, and all was left was his fish tail.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Oh, they thought they could keep God Jehovah and keep God Dagon. But I'm here to tell you, you can't keep no other God. You can't have no gods before me. You can't make no graven images, amen, to God. You can't make you a Jesus that has long hair and say, oh, holy Jesus. You can't have a holy father that walks around with a spear, having a scepter and a mitre, amen, going through the church with his holy hat and bow down and kiss his hand. I'm here to tell you, he's just a man. Amen. He might be called if he gets saved. But I'm going to tell you, I'm just a man. Peter said, get up. I'm just a man. I'm the same as you. You can serve the same God and have the same touch. Only difference, God's called me to be apostle and God's called you to be saved. Amen. Even the angel said, get up. God's the only one deserved to be praised and to be honored and to be glorified. I'm going to tell you, I ain't got no room for man to be glorified in worship. But I'm going to tell you, we need to worship God and worship him alone. I believe sometimes we set idols in our hearts and idols in our lives. And my friend, idols and God cannot coexist. Idols have to go, but God has to live. Amen. If there's idols in our heart, I pray you tear them down, because idolatry is a sin and witchcraft.
Amen.
Woo! Amen. Help us this evening, Holy Ghost.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
They said we've got to get rid of this God.
That's right.
This art judgment is coming. Our God is dying.
That's right.
They went to their little, whatever they got to make them, the little goldsmith, and said, hey, make us another God. He's dead. His head broke off. Can you weld this? Can you fix this? And they begin to make their other God. I can see it happening. And God said, I'll tell you what, I'm going to smite them with emrods. All the five lords, from the greatest city down to the smallest city. Bible says they had bleeding piles and great affliction. 50,000 people died. After 7 months of trying to deal, moving it from city to city, everywhere it went, judgment come. Everywhere it went, I'm here to tell you, you can't handle God, amen, to God, without a pure heart and a clean hands. You hear what I'm saying? There's a lot of people preaching Jesus, amen, to God. I know a drunk can preach in the word of God and have his free course, but I'm here to tell you, there's going to be a lot of judgment when we stand before God, when people have been preaching Jesus and their hearts, amen, to God, somewhere else. As Brother Hatfield said, there's a bunch of religious pimps out there getting money off our widows, amen, getting money off our good people. I'm here to tell you, Bible says, bring your tithes and offers to the storehouse. If you go, he's living right, support him. You got a home for children, you support. It says give to the fatherless. But I wouldn't give to no Tom, Dick, and Harry out there. They won't be there when you die. They won't be there when you're in the hospital. They won't be there when you're sick. But I'm going to tell you, you got a church here. Amen to God. We'll baptize you. Amen to God. We'll dedicate you. And we'll bury you. And we'll pray for you. And we'll pray for your children. This is the storehouse that you can come get what you need from heaven. I'm glad I still got a church to go to where the Holy Ghost can fall. I'm glad I still got a place I can come pray. I'm still glad I got a church that God's still God, and the Holy Ghost is still the Holy Ghost, and the Word of God still the Word of God. Woo! It grieves my heart.
Hallelujah.
Of course, I don't have Facebook and don't read Facebook. But my wife said, Hanny went home and said, she posted on her Facebook, it was so good to be back in the Holiness Church and hear good, independent Holiness preaching again. Of course, some of her family had to come on there and make a comment to her comment. He said, well, holiness is still holiness, but just people's perspective of holiness has changed. I don't care what people's perspective of holiness is. The word of God is still absolute. And there's still some absolutes in an obsolete world. You hear what I'm saying? They may try to delete them and try to take them out and try to have a new perspective on them and try to say we've been educated and we've learned better. But I'm here to say, where's the glory at? Where's the power at? They got so much, show it to me. Amen. To God, you pray and I'll pray. We'll see whose God answers by fire. Amen. God's still on the throne. And we hold as people, we sit back and we go through the rituals when we ought to stand up in spiritual humility. And said, my God's still on the throne, and I know the word of God's still the word of God, and God still has a church somewhere that I can go pray and help and get what I need from heaven. Yes. Woo! Oh, hey, hey, hey. Yes. Thank you, Holy Ghost, tonight. Yes. For your mercy and grace. I don't have no new perspective. I got the same old message that the old timers preach. Hey, Paul said, if any man come preach any of the gospel what I preached unto you, let him be accursed. If they come on with a new perspective, tell them they're wrong. Let's go back to the old Bible and preach this good word of God. There's no way. There's no living new way. Amen. Jesus is the only way. He's the only life and the only truth. And we've got to live for him and him alone. 7 months. They put her upon a new cart.
Amen.
Of course, I got ahead of myself there a little bit.
Hallelujah.
They brung it back to Israel. They let two cows with no one driving.
That's right.
Take it all the way down the coast back to Judah.
That's right.
I wonder how them cows knew. The Bible says they was lowing upon the way.
That's right.
You let a cow out of a gate, they're going to go chew in every direction they think's better. I remember as a young boy, we had cows, they stuck their head through the fence to try to get the grass that was shorter than on the other side.
Right. Amen.
I mean, it was taller inside, but they had to get what was on the other side. But them old cows, as they grazed, they went straight down the path, kind of like God leading the, amen, all the animals right into the ark, two by two. I'm here to tell you, God, the Holy Ghost is still alive. He can lead cattle, my friend, and I believe he can still lead the church. They brought them back to, amen, the Judah, the cows did. They put them right there, and all the Bethlehemites wanted to come in and look into the Ark of the Covenant. They looked in, and 70 more people just died, and they dropped the lid. They got fearful what was going on. It went 20 years without being in Jerusalem. The Ark of the Covenant wasn't there. I'm here to tell you, one day without God is long enough, more or less 20 years. Amen. All through the reign of Saul, all through Samuel's day. But you know, there come a man that was after God's own heart. He began to hear about this Ark of the Covenant. He said, I believe I'll bring it back up. I didn't even know how to carry it. He went down and said, how did it get here? It got here on a new cart. They began to take a new cart, put the Ark back on it. Amen. To God's covenant. And begin to bring it back to the city of David, Jerusalem. That was one of David's great, amen, accomplishments, was bringing worship back to the city of David. And I'm here to tell you, we can't let it leave, because it's hard enough to get back. But I believe the glory's back, and we've got to keep it back. We got to keep praying. We got to keep pressing. We got to keep going on, because if we give an inch, the devil will take another mile. We need to take this ground that we've got and keep it, amen, and keep on progressing and keep on growing and keep on going and pray more. Amen to God. Believe our God to give us a taste of what we had Sunday night. I want to see the Holy Ghost fall, not just once a year, once a week, amen, every other month, but I like to see him fall every time we come to church in his own way. Amen. Because God's still real. God's on the throne. I'm glad the glory of God's still alive.
Amen.
Woo! Amen to God.
Hallelujah.
They broke that ark. As David was trying to bring it back, it went through the threshing floor. And Uzzah reached out and touched it.
Right.
And God killed him. God killed him.
Amen.
He was just trying to be innocently save the ark.
That's right.
But God took his life.
That's right.
I'm here to tell you, you don't play around with God.
That's right. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
It's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God.
Amen.
And I'm here to tell you, if it wouldn't been for his mercy, a lot of us would have been dead.
Right.
Like Uzzah was. And like those that were in the New Testament that sold their, that lied about what they sold. I'm here to tell you, friend, if it wasn't for the mercies of God, we'd all been guilty of blurting out in church. We've all been guilty of getting up and saying things we shouldn't have said. We've all been guilty of making a fool of ourselves in front of God's people and have to shamefully hang our heads and say, God, forgive me.